What do you want now?
I've come to help you remember what you've lost. Don't pretend you don't know what I'm talking about, okay? You woke up from your crystal sleep with God's voice in your ear. He said you had to be the savior. But part of what made you lightning was missing, leaving a big empty hole in your heart.
Yeah, that's how it feels. It's like I've forgotten something important, something that I need.
Huh? Really? I thought you'd deny it. But it's okay. I'll help you remember.
Indestructible crystal. Even in the sea of chaos, it never loses its shine. I will become an eternal epitaph. Your memory will survive for eternity within a crystal tomb. This shall be my legacy and my atonement. But most of all, my final hope.
You wanted to protect her, so you fell into that crystal sleep. You became a tomb for a memory, a moment frozen in time, with Sarah's soul cocooned inside. So tell me, Lightning, where do you think Sarah is now?
Yes. I remember now. She was there, in my heart. I had her memories. They were inside me. I took them into the crystal. She was with me then. We should have been together the whole time.
Right. Now you're catching on. So, the hole in your heart?
Sarah's soul. That's what I'm missing.
And you know who took it out, don't you? Benevelza did, when he woke you up to do his bidding. He must have messed with your memories, too, and tried to make you forget about it.
And so he had the perfect motivation. Or should I say, hostage. He's gonna hold on to her until I've done what he wants.
Oh, I don't know if he thought it out that far. He's not very good with human emotions, that god of yours. Maybe he just threw her soul away and let it be swallowed up by the chaos.
But he promised me. He said as long as I did what I was told, he'd bring Sarah back to me. If he lied, then I don't care if he is a god. I'll destroy him.
Now that's more like the old Lightning. But do you really think you can take on a god?
Well, I wouldn't bet against me. I might have found a way to shut him down. A last resort if all else fails.
Oh, you've been brewing up contingency plans. Sneaky, Lightning. Very sneaky.
I haven't made up my mind yet. This world is finished. Soon it'll be gone forever. And Benevelza is the only one who can build us a new one. When he's done, then I'll decide.
So you'll play his game for as long as it takes to build the new world. Then you'll sit in judgment on him, you'll betray him and destroy him and steal the new world he labored to build. Is that your plan? I love it. Turning on God and making him a pawn in your own game. It's audacious. Oh, but Little Hope is going to be so disappointed. He really does trust you, you know, and you're going to betray him. Oh, you did think about that, didn't you? You turn on God, you turn on Hope. Are you ready for that? Do you have it in you to fight him? Are you really prepared to kill Hope?
You think I'm not?
You answered a question with a question. That's an evasion. Got ya. But it's not a big deal. It looks like Hope and talks like Hope, but it isn't Hope anymore.
Are you saying he's a fake?
Sorry, but the only fake I know is Sarah.
Look, if you're gonna talk nonsense, this conversation is over. I've got better things to do.
Fine, Lightning. Let me make it all clear. Look around you and see the lies. The Sarah you talked to is a lie. Hope in his arc is a lie. How long is it going to take before you wake up? Before you realize that maybe, just maybe, you're a lie too.
The City of Light has been the scene of much tragedy. A great number of our residents, let us offer prayers once again to Great Benevezza.
The days when he ruled the streets and urged people to rise up, well, that time is long gone.
happens, I have to win.
Require a room? Come again, anytime.
Oh, it's you again. Thank you for taking such an interest in my friend's story.
Who wouldn't? A young reporter driven by a passion for truth pursues a major case of corruption, ultimately driving an innocent woman to commit suicide. But the story's not over yet, is it? I'm curious, what happens next?
He was beyond distraught. Nothing could console him. He came to realize that the pen really was mightier than the sword. And he had used his sword to punish the wrong person. And then he... I can't continue like this. I just can't. I need to tell you the truth. He... or rather, I... thought death was the only form of penance.
I suspected you may be hiding something.
I apologize. I've been lying to you this entire time. I had no such friend. The reporter, the one who killed the innocent woman? That was me.
I had a feeling. The way you've been telling the story seems to be hitting a little too close to home.
The reporter in me died long ago. I handed in my letter of resignation immediately, of course. Along with my life as a writer, I buried my precious pen. The burial ground is now a storage area somewhere in Old Town. Underneath the dirt lies the tool of my trade, and a part of myself.
So why tell me this now? What's the point in dredging up the past? It can't be easy for you.
To tell you the truth, I don't really know. I guess I've been wanting to tell someone before it was too late. People need to know what happened. As a warning, if nothing else.
Too late? You're not thinking of...
No. I've been dead for a long time now. The day I quit my job is the day I quit being me. That's the day I quit living. You see, I'm as good as dead. I'm nothing more than an empty shell of a person.
Old Town. I found a pen in that same area. I have something that might belong to you.
Oh, you found my pen. During my days as a reporter, I never went anywhere without it. It was a gift from one of my fans.
Doesn't this pen remind you of a time you wanted to help people, when you were still naive but fiercely determined?
Yes, long ago, when I wanted justice for the world. But I realized my pen is a deadly weapon. My writing is lethal. I wasn't aware of my own powers. That's what drove an innocent woman to take her life. And that's why I quit my job as a reporter and threw away this pen. Do you? The only way to make this right was to quit what I love most.
So what did you fix?
Huh?
When you threw away your career and gave up on the world, quit on life, how did any of that help anyone? Did that make anything right? It was just an excuse for you to run and hide from your past.
Then what am I to do? Writing. It's the only thing I ever knew. My prized treasure turned out to be a weapon.
The pen can harm people, but it can also protect the public.
You think I should start writing again? I don't know if I could do that. Or should do that.
You should. If you truly want to make things right, people grow by learning from their mistakes. It's impossible to forget what happened in the past. But use that knowledge and do what only you can do.
Do you really think I can? All right, I'll do it. You've returned my pen to me, but what's more, you've given me hope again. Thank you. Thank you. Are all ticking happily away. I hope you can relax now.
Thank you. If I had failed to inspect the clocks and they had stopped, I don't know what I would have done. I would have felt responsible for the world coming to an end. I wouldn't have been able to keep living, not with that kind of guilt on my shoulders.
I'm glad I could put your mind at ease, but
that's encouraging.
What can I say? It's inevitable.
Yes, I do know that. But that's the reason why I care for the clocks so much. I don't want to wait for the Savior to come and do all the work.
Why is that? You don't trust her?
No, it's not that. When the world ends, I want to be absolutely sure. I want to be 100% certain that I finished the task that I was meant to do.
No regrets, is that it?
Yes. That's exactly right. Even if the Savior doesn't show up to save the whole of mankind, I can face the end with pride.
Maybe not everyone needs to be saved by God. Maybe completing your duty is the way.
Has Marlin arrived?
Well?
I did. I have it with me now, in fact.
That's fantastic!
Don't get too excited. You don't remember what's written in it for good reason. You made yourself forget. And some things are better left forgotten. Are you ready to accept the reality of your past? If not, please don't read it.
What do you mean, the reality of my past? I'd like to know. I may regret my decision, but yes, I'd like to read it. I'm prepared to face the truth.
You're absolutely sure?
Yes.
All right. Here it is.
I remember now. I had a wife and daughter, but they were taken from me. The killer was never caught, though not for a lack of trying. I pursued him with a vengeance for years, decades even.
Whether out of frustration or rage, eventually it became too much for you to bear. Your mind chose to forget that tragic event so you could keep on going with your life.
I can't believe I've been living a lie for so long. How could I have erased the memory of my lovely wife, my beautiful daughter, their laughter, their love?
I'm sorry. Maybe recovering the journal, maybe it wasn't for the best.
No, I'm grateful you helped me remember what happened. I needed to remember. Thank you. The truth surrounding the incident is still a mystery to this day. This can't be the way it ends. I need to know what happened to my family and why. I need closure. Truth is the only thing that will help me go on with my life.
Are you sure? You don't know the things you might uncover.
I'm sure.
Hope, I need to find out the truth behind this. I owe it to him. He deserves it. Now that he remembers his past, he needs closure.
He summoned up all of his courage to face the truth. The least we can do is help him learn it all. I'll do whatever I can to help. Just say the word. Oh, I don't know if this will help, but I may have found something regarding the case.
Anything would help at this point.
I found an old newspaper article about what happened to Renault's family. Unfortunately, it doesn't contain anything we already don't know.
But that means there's a reporter out there who knows all about this case.
That's true. There is a chance they may know something that can lead us in the right direction. It's not much, but let's pursue it.
Welcome to our...
We eagerly await your next visit.
You're back! Do you want to buy some tears?
Explain to me why I should have to pay more than before.
Are you questioning the market value of my tears? They're special. Only for special people.
All right. You've talked yourself up quite a bit.
No, I can't. Not for you.
You've certainly got a knack for testing my patience.
Since you already gave me your money, I'll tell you a big secret instead. Do you know how I cry for people? Can you imagine the things I think of?
Something sad, like your pointless existence?
No, Miss Smarty Pants. I don't think of anything. I just empty my head. Then, like magic, the tears come.
So, you're a born fraud.
You mean actress. I had a great mentor.
Who was that?
My acting coach. He's the one who taught me to become one with my role. Master that, and the acting would come naturally. He taught me everything I know. This might seem silly, but I kept acting to spend time with him.
You really cared for him.
I loved him. But look at me. Even though we spent decades together, he never stopped treating me like a child. Who can blame him, really? He died some time ago in an accident. I didn't have the heart to keep acting after that. I just couldn't. Without him watching my performance, it all seemed so pointless.
So that's why you quit.
I thought it was time. I went through a few things after that, nothing I'll bore you with. And now I'm here, selling my tears. So this is my calling.
That's an optimistic way to look at things. But I have to ask, doesn't the past make you cry?
Tears dry up, you know. I cried every day for 100 years after he passed away. But not anymore. I can cry to keep my business going, but that's something completely different. And that's enough talk for today.
She's awfully cheerful for someone who cries for a living, don't you think?
She does seem happy, at least on the surface. But sometimes people laugh when they're crying on the inside.
Called Armand. Every day he comes out to stand on the street and does nothing but talk to himself. Hey, he's an odd one, all right. If you happen to see Armand, don't worry. You'll know him when you see him. Say hello, would you? He and I go way back, though everything's changed since those days. I just wish there was something I could do for him. Do you know the fellow called...
Target acquired.
Oh,
Guess I'll just have to do what I can. I challenge you. Time for a counterattack. strike you down.
Let's go.
switch it up. Gotta keep up.
Thank you.
miracles when there is a hypothesis that a vanished labyrinth lies somewhere in this world. But the name itself would imply that it does not.
People all say the end is coming.
Hey, little miss up and coming. I'm off to look for Cruxes. I've got a knack for finding Cruxes, though I won't hand them over for free, of course. Thanks for the business.
Go on! Which do you take?
Band that everyone's talking about, aren't you?
Well, I don't listen to rumors.
Ooh, look at Little Miss Antisocial. Well, I'm Jameis, former bandit.
Former?
Sure, now I'm just a useless sponge soaked in booze. I drink a whole ocean of chaos if it drown my sorrows. I've been away from the desert for a while now, but I came right back when I heard about you, girlie.
And what do I have to do with anything?
Sit back and let me tell you the tale about my days as a greedy bandit. I'd do anything. I'd pick a ruin clean and then go right back out for more. Even someone like me had a family. But 156 years ago, on a day I can't forget, a day I don't want to remember!
Then don't. No one's asking you to.
Hold on, please. I've come all this way. At least hear me out. That day I had taken the kids with me to the ruins. It was just a regular day of exploration. Until those damn skeletons appeared. There wasn't time to get the kids away. Only one who survived.
Was you. So you've been blaming yourself and plotting your vengeance? Is that it?
You overestimate a drunk like me. You think a washed-up loser like me has the guts to seek vengeance? I just turned tail and ran away.
Yet you came back to the desert now.
I did. You managed to open the seals that no one else has been able to do a thing about. When I heard that, I knew that if anyone could help me, it was you. I've got to ask you a favor. I know you don't owe me a thing, but you're the only one I can ask. Please, destroy every last one of those skeleton bastards. What?
You couldn't save the children, but you think this might help.
I know it's too much to ask a stranger, and I...
Never mind that. It won't be easy, though.
I'll repay you somehow for this.
You found the remains for me. I'm sure they're glad to be out of that dark hole, too. Thank you for setting them free.
You can't push yourself too high. You're always welcome.
grant the Forsaken world more time.
You survived another day.